death angels coming. Get your house in order. Prepare for that moment. A young boy is crying, 'cause he's scared of dying. But with morning's light, he finds he's alright. Because words of the Lord placed over the door, my sin debt is paid. I'm not afraid anymore. The Lamb has been slain, and now I am free. The sentence of death has passed over me. I now live in His love. Because of the blood, the preacher was preaching, judgment is coming. You better get ready and keep the warning. I too was crying, I knew I was dying. Forgive me, I pray. And now I am saved because of the blood placed over the door. My sin debt is paid. I'm not afraid anymore. The Lamb has been slain, and now I am free. The sentence of death has passed over me. I now live in His love. Because of the blood, I was locked in chains and heavy bounds when He came and rescued me. Opened up my blinded eyes, and now I can see. I can see. Because of the blood placed over the door, my sin debt is paid. I'm not afraid anymore. The Lamb has been slain, and now I am free. The sentence of death has passed over me. I now live in His love. Because of the blood, I now live in His love. Ooh, because of the blood. John said He is precious. By leaning on His bosom, so for a moment may I humbly testify. Did I mention that I love Him? And adore Him when I can see no way. He makes a way. And did I mention He's been faithful? Brought me to my knees.
Every mountain, every desert, everything that's ever come our way to keep us where we need to be with Him. Amen. If you have your Bible, let's go to 1 Corinthians chapter 9. How many has ever been hurt in church? If you have never been hurt in church, hold on, you will. It happens. How many has ever been hurt outside the church? It happens. Got a message that's been laid on my heart. And, the Bible talks about in the last few people falling away, and I believe that we're seeing it today. Seems like it's just more and more. But we're also seeing a great move of God. I want to preach a little while on this song about finish the race. In 1 Corinthians chapter 9, I want to start reading in verse 20. You there, say amen. And unto the Jews, I became as a Jew, that I might gain the Jews, and to them that are under the law, as under the law, that I might gain them that are under the law, to them which are without the law, as without law, being not without law to God, but under the law to Christ, that I might gain them that are without the law. To the weak became I as weak, that I might gain the weak. I am made all things to all men, that I might be all means, by all means, save some. And this I do for the gospel's sake, that I might be partakers thereof with you. Know ye not that they which run in a race run all, but one receiveth the prize? So run that you may obtain. And every man that striveth for the mastery is temperate in all things. Now they do it to obtain a corruptible crown, but we an incorruptible. I therefore so run, not as uncertainly, so fight I, not as one that beateth the air, but I keep under my body, and bring it into subjection, lest by any means, when I preach to others, I myself should be a castaway. God, I love you. I thank you for your word. I thank you, God, for what we can already feel this morning, folks already on the altar. And Lord, I pray right now, Lord, you just help us to God. Lord, to be able to bring this message, Lord, in a way, God, that the people would receive it, dear God, and know it's from you. And Lord, I pray right now, Lord, you touch Christians. God, I realize this message is more to Christians today, God, than anybody else. And I ask your hand to be upon us. I pray, God, you would send conviction in the building. In Jesus' name, amen. Why start a race if you're not going to finish it? I don't know about you, but I remember in school when we would have a race, if I was going to run in the race, I was going to do my best to win the race. I never done anything just to be doing it. I wasn't that kind of person. If I was going to do something, Brother Joe, I wanted to win. Why in the world, people, would you want to race if you're not going to win? Why would you go out there and work hard and build a car to race or train if you're not going to strive to win the race? But you know what really upsets me? To be in a race and watch somebody quit. Just quit. And we have that today. People just, they start this race for the Lord, and they start this race to make heaven their home. And the Bible talks about we're striving for an incorruptible crown. And I just see people tell me, just every day, just quit. I don't understand that. The Bible says in Ecclesiastes chapter 9, verse 10 and 11, whatsoever thy hand find to do, do it with thy might, for there is no work, nor device, nor knowledge, nor wisdom in the grave whither thou goest. I returned and saw under the sun that the race is not to the swift, nor the battle to the strong, neither yet bread to the wise, nor yet riches to men of understanding, nor yet favor to men of skill, but time and chance happeneth to them all. We all know the story of the tortoise and the hare, the story growing up, we've all heard that about how the turtle and the rabbit were racing, and the rabbit just nonchalantly took it, and the turtle won. So if we're going to start a race, we ought to at least want to finish it. I'm preaching to Christians right now. We got folks in the building right now. I'm going to be honest with you. Some of you, yeah. I'm not sure if you're in the race or not. We need to make up our minds. I'm going to be in the race. I'm going to do what I'm supposed to do. Now, why do some people not finish the race? This is the thing about the message. Why, Dallas, why do some people not finish the race? As I was studying and looking at some things, and I was looking at racing and different things like that, and it's amazing how God just puts things together. Number one, I want you to think about it. An injury can make you not finish the race. I remember watching the 1984 Olympics. I remember this. I can close my eyes and see it. There was a young lady, an American lady named Mary Decker. She was running, and she was running in the race. She was favored to win the gold. She was running, and somebody bumped her brother Robert, and she twisted her leg. And I remember she fell to the inside on the track there, and she was grabbing her ankle. She was injured, and she did not finish the race. How many of us today have been injured in the race? Somebody hurt you. Somebody bumped you. You didn't like the way they bumped you. And so now you're no longer in the race like you need to be. I mean, just apply this to your life and apply this to church. We've all been hurt in church. We've all had our feelings hurt. We've all, been shunned in some way, shape, or form. And we've all had to go through the injuries. But I understand something. This lady, she didn't let that, she went back out and she got healed and she ran the race again. She didn't just quit. Some are injured by others. Some are injured by themselves. If you can look these up on the internet. Derek Redmond, a great runner in the 1992 Olympics. He pulled a hamstring in the 400-meter race. And I've told you about this one before, how his father came from out of the stands and helped him finish the race. He limped around. He was injured right by himself. Nobody bumped him. Nobody hit him. He was just running. And all of a sudden, he grabbed his hamstring. He was injured by it. I want you to understand something. Most of the time in my life, in my church family, in my church life, I've done it to myself. I can't blame it on nobody else. I can't blame it on the preacher. I can't blame it on the deacons. I can't blame it on this one. I can't blame it on that one. I injured myself in the race, and I'm the one that had to deal with it. So why don't you finish the race? Injuries ain't got to keep you from the race. I told you about Derek Redmond. His father came down and helped him finish the race. There was one called Abby Diagnostico in the 2016 Olympics. She fell, and another runner came by Brother Law and picked her up and helped her finish the race. Just because you get injured don't mean you got to quit. Just because you get injured don't mean you got to stop. Just because you get injured don't mean you got to just lay there and wallow in it. The Bible says in 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 8 to 9, we are troubled on every side, yet not distressed. We are perplexed, but not in despair. Persecuted, but not forsaken. Cast down, but not destroyed. I got somebody there to help me. His name is Jesus. And if I get injured, if I can call out on Him, He can help me through the race. When's the last time you helped somebody in the race? Let's just get honest. But like I told you, when I would race, I wanted to win. I'm just being honest. Y'all can talk about me if you want to. This is the truth. If I knocked you down in the race, I might come back and check on you after the race is over. I'm just being honest. I'm just being honest. But I don't run the Christian race that way. Somebody knocks Logan down, and I'm going to stop and help Logan. Because me and Logan got the same goal in mind. We need to make sure we all finish the race. Amen? And when somebody, I don't know why God got this on, but when somebody misses church a couple of weeks, you ought not come to them and say, "Where in the world have you been? Do I need to get you a visitor card? Have you just quit?" I know I got on somebody. But you'll get over it. You'll either get over it or have to get on Auburn and ask God to forgive you. That's not the way to help people finish the race. The way to help people finish the race is build them up. Just like I was preaching a few weeks ago, edify each other, build them up. It's our job to help people finish the race. Now, some just quit. They don't get injured. You can't blame it on nothing else. They just quit the race. I read this, and coaches tell runners, if you drop out of one race even once, it will become a habit. It don't take but one time for it to become a habit. And once you start dropping out, guess what? You'll keep dropping out. It don't take but just one. I told you about the guy that went to South Avenue. I've said this many times. Went to South Avenue way back in the day. And I talked to him. He said he'd been out of church for 30 years. And I asked him, I said, "What in the world happened?" He said, "I can take you to the day that I got out of church. He said, went to choir practice. He said, the choir was packed. Wasn't no more room in the choir. He said, the devil said, they don't need you. He said, from that I started missing on Wednesday night every once in a while. He said, after that, I'd start missing on Sunday nights. And after a while, he said, I'd start missing a Sunday every once in a while. He said, the next thing I knew, I was out of church for 30 years. So you need to have a made-up mind. I'm going to church. I'm staying in the race. If you're going to stay at home on Sunday morning and lay in the bed, you ain't in the race. If you're going to stay at home on Sunday night, you ain't in the race. If you're going to lay at home on Wednesday night, you ain't in the race. Ryan Hall. Most people have never heard about this people. I'd never heard it until I started studying, because I don't keep up with racing very much. But Ryan Hall holds the U.S. record for a half marathon. He run a half marathon, which is about, 13 miles? Something like that. He run a half marathon in 59 minutes and 43 seconds. But just to let y'all know, that's cooking it pretty good. He is the only American to ever run a full marathon in 2 minutes, 2 hours, 4 minutes, and 58 seconds. That's a little over 26 miles. You know what he's best known for? In 2015, in the Los Angeles Marathon, he quit for no reason. Just quit. Just quit. He didn't get injured. Preacher Mikey didn't get injured. Didn't nobody bump him. I mean, it wasn't raining. Just decided, I don't want to run no more. And to me, that's what he'll go down as being remembered for. So, I mean, why do some people quit? Well, some people quit because they get too busy. Too busy. I ain't got time for church. I don't have time for church. I don't have time to dedicate myself that much to one thing. I don't have time. I don't have time for me. I don't have time to go get up on Sunday morning. You know, I work so hard through the week, and I work all these hours through the week. Sunday's my time. I don't have time to get up and go to Sunday school. I don't have time. You know, you can get up at 5 o'clock every morning and go to work, but you can't make it to Sunday school at 10 o'clock. Either in the race or yanked. Some people just get too busy. I mean, there's not enough time to do the things I want to do. Not only that, some people quit racing because it's too hot or too cold. Some people quit racing because it hurts, you know. They don't train. If me and Brother Robert would go out and try to run a foot race, say 4 or 5 miles, you know, I wouldn't finish. I quit. I hadn't trained for it. I'm not prepared for it. I'm not going to get out there and put myself through that. Now, if you want to walk it, I'll walk it with you. But I'm talking about being in a race. They haven't prepared for it. I had a friend of mine. I'm not going to call no names, but his daddy was a great dirt track racer. I mean, this man, it wouldn't have took but just a little bit more, Brother Joe, for him to go to the next level of racing. That's how good his daddy was. I went to school. I grew up with these people in the same community with these people. His daddy was a great racer. Well, his son, which is a year older than I am, he wanted to race. His daddy built him a car. They got out there, you know, and everything. And he had the car built just like his car. He was ready for his son to race. That joker run dead last ever race he went in. He didn't have the nerve there to get up in there and race. Didn't take him long, Mike, and quit. You're either going to dedicate yourself to it, or you're not going to do it at all. You just can't be a half-in Christian and a half-out Christian. It don't work that way. God tells us to follow Him with our whole heart. That means everything we got. That means I'm going to be dedicated to everything I got. I don't want to quit the race. If it hurts, I'm still going. If I have to get up in the morning and I ain't slept all night long, I'm still going. I'm staying in the race. It don't matter what happens. Hey, some people just lose their motivation. They just get discouraged. Hey, I want you to understand something. Jesus has done a lot more for me than anybody else can do against me. So I ought not let things discourage me and get me out of the race. Bible says in 2 Chronicles, chapter 15, verse 7, be ye strong, therefore, and let not your hands be weak, for your work shall be rewarded. We got a reward, folks. That ought to be our motivation. The reward that we have. Now listen, some of them get disqualified. As I was studying this and thinking, I remember when Ben Johnson got disqualified for drugs. Lost a gold medal in the Olympics because of drugs. One of the greatest runners in American history, Marion Jones, had all her medals and all her wins taken away from her because of drugs. But when I found out this, you know what the number one reason for disqualification for a runner is? Josh, I like to fell out when I saw this. The number one reason for disqualification for a runner is false start. So let that sink into your Christian life. You know why a lot of people get out the race? Because they never started the race the right way. I'm going to be honest with you. We got people in this church right now. We got people in this church right now with their name on the church roll that ain't saved. Oh, preacher, you trying to judge me. I'm not trying to judge. I'm just telling you like it is. There's a lot of people went down and had an emotional experience. They went through the motions. And just because grandma and granddaddy and daddy and mama and all of them started the church and they was in the church and you had your name on the church, that don't mean you're saved. I want you to understand something. You ain't never got down an altar and asked God to forgive you of your sins and come to a personal knowledge of Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior and changed your ways and quit doing the stupid stuff you was always doing and changed and started living. You ain't saved. I don't care what your Bible school teacher told you. I don't care what your Sunday school teacher told you. There ain't but one way to be saved, and that's by the blood of Jesus, and you'll know it when you get it. What we think is disqualification, most of them never even started the race to start with. So John chapter 3, verse 3, Jesus answered and said to him, verily, verily, I say unto you, except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. Now, as I was studying this, I got thinking about it. And I've talked about people being injured. I was kind of running through this in my mind, I was kind of thinking, you know, falling. Some people quit because they fall. I've seen it. I've seen races where somebody would start the race. Alan, they'd start the race, and all of a sudden, and something happened, and they fall. And they laid it. I remember watching a race one time. This guy fell down with Brother Robert. He got up, he set up, and he was just beating the ground. Just beating the ground. Mad cause he fell. There was a man, I think he's French. His name's Lasse Varin. Now, you listen to this. In 1972, he was running in the Olympics, a 1,000-meter runner. He fell in the middle of the race. Now, listen, true story. He fell in the middle of the race, Brother Wayne, and got up and won the race, won the gold medal, and set an Olympic record. That's the kind of runner I want to be. Let me go. Hey, y'all look up at me real good. I have fallen many times in this race. I'm talking about fall on my face, got scraped, got bruises, been beat up one side down the other. But I'm telling you right now, I'm getting ready to show you a clip of a young lady. This girl's name is Heather Dorrington. She runs a 600 meter race. You got that video, David? I want y'all to watch this video. Make sure the volume's up. Think about your Christian race as you're watching this.
The 600 meter underway. Heather Dorrington in Minnesota finished second this fact a year ago. She was in lane four. And Dorrington is probably going to be your favorite. She actually won the NCAA championships in 2006 in the 800, but she only won one Big Ten championships in the 2 years. Three laps in this event, 600 meters, three times around the 200 meter track here at the field house.
What a bold move by Fallon. She's looking very confident, and the Penn State runner is just running amazing today. She did win her heat in the 400, but ended up taking fourth overall.
That's Fallon Dorr moving into the lead, a sophomore from Penn State.
This is how a Christian ought to live their life right here.
Second. Dorrington last year scored 23 points for the Golden Gophers in their Big Ten championship, so they're really relying on getting a lot of points from her this weekend, and she's just coming by Fallon Dorr now in the home stretch, heading into the bell lap.
Dorrington falling down, gets up quickly, but that's going to cost her. Lucky she wasn't injured.
Her teammate just went to the front, though, so they may be able to recover from that. And Dorrington is flying down the back stretch.
She is catching up.
She is going to catch Fallon Dorr, and she may catch the leader.
Wow.
But she's got fun.
This is a gutsy effort by Dorrington. Can't she pull it off? She's moving to third. Dorrington coming down the stretch from the outside. Dorrington coming on strong. Dorrington all the way. Dorrington.
That is amazing. To fall in a 600, I mean, this is basically a...
You notice what happened when she fell. She didn't sit there and blame nobody. She didn't gripe about what happened. She hit the dirt, and she got right back up. And she kept on running. And she might not have won by 100 foot. But glory to God, she won. Whereas if she'd have just laid there, Brother Robert, that's what she'd have been known for. Just laying there. Some of y'all need to wake up. Aren't you tired of just laying there, belly aching, and griping about everything going on in your life? Won't you get up and finish the race? That's what we ought to do. Just get up and finish the race. Me and David was watching this, and the time she fell, that got one of them out said, "That's going to cost her." I thought about that's what church folks say. It's going to cost her. Oh, she ain't got no chance now. So that little girl, she proved them wrong. Why don't you go ahead and make up your mind? I'm going to prove everybody wrong. I'm staying faithful. I'm finishing the race. Understand something. I got a prize to get to. She knew that wasn't the end of the race. Just because you fall, don't mean you got to quit. Just because you fall, don't mean you got to lay there. Get back up and go for the prize. You might have to run a little harder than you were running to start with. I thought about, you know, maybe if that girl had the rock, she could have probably won by about a half a mile. The way she was running for Jamal, she'd have had a made up mind like that to start with. She'd have been so far out front, they'd have never called her. Candace, where you at? Come back up here and sing sometimes. It takes a minute. I like it when God just gives it to you. If she hadn't failed Melvin, she'd have never known what was on the inside. If she hadn't failed, she'd have never knew I could do that. And sometimes it takes falling. Now listen, it wasn't the coach's fault she fell. It was somebody else's fault she fell. But sometimes it takes falling just so you'll know I can do this. With God's help, I can do this. With the Lord helping me, I can do this. As long as I got Jesus on my side, I ain't quitting. I'm not going to stop. I'm not going to slow down. Hey, if I get knocked down, I'm getting back up. I'm going to keep right on going. It don't matter what nobody... They can tell me it's going to cost me all they want to. They don't know what's on the inside. They don't know who I got living on the inside. They don't know there's somebody... I got a coach on the inside that's telling me, you can do this. Get up and keep going. Don't you quit. Don't listen to everybody else. Aren't you glad she couldn't hear the announcer? All she could hear maybe Robert. Brother Tony was her coach from the sideline saying, run, you got it. Go, go. Listen, that's what Jesus is telling you this morning. Just keep on going. Whatever's knocked you down, don't you let it keep you down. Whatever's bothering you this morning, don't you let it get you out of the race. I'm telling you, there's a prize to get to, and it's called heaven. And if it takes a mountain or a desert or whatever it takes to get you where you need to be, you ought to get on this altar and thank God. It's hard to look back on a life and say thank God for the falls. It's hard to look back on a life and say thank God for the injuries. But my Bible says all things work too good to them that love the Lord and who are the called according to His purpose. God, we love you. God, I ain't asking for hands, God, because we've all been hurt. God, we've all fallen. We've all gone down. We've all... Some of us, Lord, I'm going to be honest with you. Sometimes, Lord, I've laid there and walked in. But God, help me to be the kind of runner that'll get back up. And I might not set a record, God, but Lord, I just want to finish the race. Help me right now, God. Help us right now, God. In Jesus' name. Amen. If you would just stand. What you going through? What's the devil been telling you? Now it's time to quit. Now it's time to stop.
I face the mountain that I never had before.
What's the devil telling you?
That's why I'm calling.
We all gonna fall. We all gonna make mistakes. Because you make a mistake, Jesus don't know your way.
My Lord, please hear my prayer. I need your life, I never had before. Sometimes the chains are mounted. Sometimes the struggle seems. Sometimes it takes a desert to get a hold of me. Your love is so much stronger than whatever struggles me. Sometimes it takes a mountain.
A lot of people fall. They think, I can't win now.
To trust you,
it ain't no good now. 1 John 1:9. If we confess our sin, He's faithful and just to forgive us our sin and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. He wants you back. He wants you back.
I thought I could control whatever life could throw my way. But this, I will admit, has brought me to my knees. I need you, Lord, and I'm not ashamed to say.
Why don't you get in the race?
Sometimes it takes
time. Give it a thought and get in the race. But if you don't ever get in the race, you ain't going to heaven.
Sometimes it's trouble.
Just because you fall don't mean you disqualify. Won't you come?
Sometimes it takes a desert.
I need to be safe. You come down this altar, I'll pray with you.
To get a hold of me. Your love is so much stronger.
Listen to what that says right there.
Than whatever troubles me.
His love is
so strong. Sometimes it takes
a mile. Won't you come get help?
To trust you and believe. Sometimes it takes a mountain to trust you and believe.
Thank you.